Good evening. Welcome to Anfield, where things haven't been too great just lately. 5 weeks ago, Liverpool led the Premiership by 7 points. Since then, they've managed just 1 point in 5 games and been knocked out of the Champions League. Still, they can't fail tonight, can they? Mind you, this third round UEFA Cup tie is not as secure as it should be.
No sound. No light.
Europe is of paramount importance for Liverpool.
It's a win in! And Liverpool leads. And now it's a two-man break, Baroš, and this is Owen in on goal, chased by Cornelissa, and the goalkeeper did well and survives with fortune. Here is Smica. Another opportunity for killing the game stone dead. It's burned by Liverpool. Mustafa hits the post! Oh no!
A win away from home in Europe is always a great win.
More than happy with a 1-0 victory away from home.
So Liverpool bring a one-goal lead back to Anfield, and we've brought back Alan and Mark. Alan, you know, Liverpool are under a bit of pressure tonight. I mean, it should be comfortable, but things are not great at the
moment. Yeah, not a lot of good news about here. I mean, the last time, or the first leg, they'd taken 1.9 in the Premiership, and I thought that was a bit of a challenge. Now it's 1 out of 15, you're heading towards a crisis. The only way you can avert that crisis is by doing it on the football pitch. And normally, in a game like this, you'd say, win the match and worry about the performance later. I think they'll win the match easily because Vitesse were light in the first leg. I didn't think they were any good. But I think it's imperative that Liverpool put on a performance tonight where they're solid and reliable, dependable and knocking a few goals, because the only way you can get the confidence back is by doing it on the pitch. I mean, they've got a big game on Sunday against Sunderland. And I think tonight it is really important that they go out there, they start quickly. There's not going to be a big crowd in there, so the atmosphere is going to be a bit dull. But they've got to start quickly. Start quickly, get after them, and make sure that when they score 2 or 3 goals, they pile on the pressure and get more. Because, as I say, the only way you can get back is collectively. You can't do it individually. That's always what they've done here. You're laughing.
I've just heard you say that a few times over the years.
But that's what they always say.
Yeah.
Collectively is the only way you're going to get back to where you
They've got to stop the rot. Basically.
Yeah, exactly. And they will not get a better opportunity than tonight, because... We said in the first game, Vitesse Arnhem were very ordinary, and that's been quite nice to them as well. Apparently, they are a better side away from home. But
They'll need to be.
But Liverpool have to use this as a starting block. And I think, as Alan says, won't be great atmosphere here at all. You're going to have to get the crowd going. You're going to have to generate their own atmosphere. Score a couple of goals early on, you're always going to have a chance. And, you know, confidence is a funny thing in most ball games, especially football, as we know. And if they can start here tonight, then obviously you're thinking in terms of the slump, that can be forgotten.
You don't want the reverse, where they start slowly and then get a bit edgy in the crowd, just get on their back a bit, and you know, and then you've got an easy pass from A to B and you put it to Z. You know what that sort of thing's like.
I remember it well. Now, when the weather's as cold as it's been this week, you've got a slightly better chance than normal to get Mr. Hansen off the golf course, especially if it's to interview the Liverpool captain, Sammy Hoopier.
So, Sammy, after a great start to the season, it's been 1 point out of 15 in the Premiership and out of the Champions League, what exactly has gone wrong?
Of course, it's mentally very hard to go through this period, but I think we haven't played so bad. We're still creating chances and they just not seem to go in, and at the other end we are conceding a little bit too easy goals, but... But yeah, I think now everybody just have to keep it together and keep working hard, and it'll come.
Do you think it's a case of that if you have one really good result where you maybe bang in a few goals and you keep a clean sheet, then you'll have turned the corner?
Yeah, I think so. Every victory in any game gives the team a confidence, and I think confidence is one of the things we need at the moment, and if we can play one game that we bang a lot of goals in, then I think it'll turn it around, and everybody's is more relaxed, and we trust each other more and trust yourself more, and I think that's the thing we have to try to do now.
Well, you've just said the next game is the most important one. It'd be great for Liverpool and for you as captain if you could score 5 or 6 goals and look very solid and reliable and keep a clean sheet. Is that going to happen?
It's not going to be an easy game. All the Dutch side are quite a good side, so away game in Arnhem, we had a lot of chances to score even more, and we were a bit lucky at the end that they missed the sitter to draw a game 1-1, but yeah, I think now home game we just have to go for it and try to score more than one, but it's yeah, I think one goal is enough to go through, and that's what we want.
Do you think this is more of a challenge than a crisis?
I think it's a challenge. I think we have to show everybody that we are mentally strong to get over this, and I believe in this squad and in this club that we can do good things here, and I hope everybody is patient enough to just be behind the team all the way, and I think judging a team in the middle of the season is not good anyway. I think in May what we can everybody can judge us the way they want when they see how we stand in May.
Do you think Liverpool will win the championship?
I have to believe it, and we have every aspect in our game to win it. Of course, I know that Arsenal, United and Chelsea, they are very good teams, but we are not a bad team either.
It's like a cross between Jeremy Paxman and James Bond there, aren't you?
Yeah, like Jenny Bond maybe.
Basildon Bond, about Jenny Bond.
But a great responsibility in Sammy, really becoming one of the better players. The captain aside, what this group needs is leadership from somewhere. Ideally, you want somebody in the middle of the park that could get the game with the scruff of the neck and show that sort of leadership.
It's amazing, Mark, though, isn't it, for a club that were playing so well and pretty much winning every week, and all of a sudden, I mean, we can have a look at a stat here that shows the last 8 games, they've only won, as Alan said before, one of them.
In all honesty, Gary, since Gerard Houllier has taken over from Roy Evans, they've had a November or a December which has been very, very similar. Yeah. Even when they won those 3 trophies, I seem to recall they hardly got any points this time of year. I don't know if that relates to the training methods, if it just relates to the fact that, you know, this is their dip, as it were, in the season. I think, as Sammy Hupia says, you know, you win nothing around November, December time, but you have to reiterate that it's got to stop tonight. That this is the place
before
where
that Middlesbrough match, they'd won 8 and 9. Yeah. 8 games and 9.
Alan, 26 games unbeaten they've gone, including towards the end of last year. Yeah.
But away form for me is everything. And if you look at the 3 away defeats that they've had, Middlesbrough, Fulham, Charlton, not exactly teams that are right at the top of the tree. And what happens is, the minute they start underperforming, the cynics come out. Something wrong here, something wrong there. No variation of tactics.
They haven't got any width, though.
When
you're winning, when you lose, they still haven't got any. And it, you know, I mean, Smeets a place tonight, and for me, would still be an enigma in this side.
Yeah.
You know, because that position he plays in.
I mean, this is the team for Liverpool tonight. I mean, this perhaps is a game a year or two ago, if they were going well, that he'd have played a few players that wouldn't be that regular.
He would have arrested 11 of them last year, but. I mean, he's playing a relatively strong side, strong defensively. Smitzer, they've got him wide on the left there, he won't play there. I think he'll play just off the front two. I mean, it's a strong enough side to go and win the game comfortably. I think, again, it's how they start the match. I think if they go out and start at a high tempo, then they can get after Arnhem or Vitesse and, you know, and score 2 or 3 goals. Obviously, The big thing again there is Michael Owen hasn't scored in the last five. Yeah. When he's not scoring, then
no one else does. Generally, no. Unlike, say, Arsenal, Manchester United, where they can come from.
You know, and El Hadji Diouf at the moment, I mean, the jury's still very much out on him at the moment. So Salih Jow's done really well since he's come in. But, you know, go back to the Smeets point, and that position he plays, and we've got him on the left side of midfield on the captain, but he'll probably play off the front two. He's got to be dominant, and he's got to be stronger. He's got to be stronger.
Alan, you were calling for Jerzy Dudek to be dropped for the good of Liverpool, even though you said he was a good goalkeeper. They brought Chris Kirkland in. What do you make of him? You see much of him? Or?
I haven't seen that much of him. Apparently, he was excellent against Southampton in the Worthington Cup. And, I mean, the goals that they lost on Saturday, Charlie, you couldn't blame them at all. I mean, the thing about Kirkland is they're talking about him being Seaman's successor for England. He can't get in the Liverpool side. And that's basically because if you look at the last 18 months, you could argue that Dudek's been the best player. He's been that good. Yeah. Until the game against Middlesbrough, then he's had a blip and loss of form. But obviously there, the three saves he makes against Michael, are really good. They're top draw. But, I mean, it's a big, big pressure game to come. No, I'm not talking about this game in particular, but taking over Liverpool this time when the confidence is really low. I mean,
it's
so much
proper
pressure.
Test. You've got to find out sometime.
You've got to get a bigger test than
but
this.
But in terms of goalkeeping, he's a baby, isn't he? I mean, he's probably another 15 years at the very, very top, but as you say, you've got to test him at some stage.
OK, chaps. Now also playing the UEFA Cup tonight are Fulham, Leeds and Celtic. And we'll have action from all their games at half-time. But first, it's Liverpool versus Vitesse Arnhem with Trevor Brooking and Barry Davis.
The crowd greet the two teams. And it's perhaps worth recalling that on December the 12th, 2001, Liverpool were held at Anfield 0-0 by Fulham and started a poor run.
Tonight's team,
the supporters will be hoping that the team led by Sammy Hapia will tonight on December the 12th, 2002, end their depressing run. So let's check on the two teams. As far as Gerard Houllier's lineup is concerned, there are four differences from the team that played in the first leg. Chris Kirkland for Dudek in goal, as you've been hearing. Carragher for Marcus Babbel, who is one of the substitutes. Hajdúf for Barros, who is also a substitute. And Smeetsa for Cheyrou, whom he replaced in the first match. Change of names, but no change of tactics.
No, we've got them with the 4-4-2. Lads were saying Smeetsa could play behind the front two. I've also seen Owen play up through the middle by himself, and you could have Smeetsa and El Hadjouf either side of him. I think number 9, El Hadjouf, has got to start producing some of the form everyone was hoping for at the start of the season.
17, Steven Gerrard. Vitesse Arnhem, who are well supported. The crowd over to the goal on the left. They have two changes. Michael Jonsson, who's 18 years old and who's never played in the first team before, comes into the centre of the defence in place of the injured Marian Zeman, the Slovak international. And Bob Peters, the Belgian, replaces Mustafa. They have no fewer than seven left-sided players, and it's an attacking choice made by their coach.
Well, you mentioned Michael Jonsson, a big test for him at the centre. You know, coming here to Anfield. I thought also Peters, the number 19, very tall player, give them an option, and certainly Amaro is quite quick as Mbamba. So it looks as if they are, certainly they've got to score tonight, and they're looking to try and get those away goals.
The substitutes bench, as I said, Barros, Babbel, Dietmar Hamann, who's probably been the most consistent player for Liverpool this season, and number 33, a new name, Neil Mellor, who's the son of Ian, the former Manchester City player, who made an impressive debut here 8 days ago in the Worthington Cup. The officials come from Germany, and the referee is Wolfgang Stuck. Divides the teams from the first leg. Gerrard, restored to the centre of the midfield. Jamie Carragher. It's a chilly night, but not as cold as it has been, although it seems to have been colder in the south than it has been in the north, which doesn't happen too often. Johnsons in the team, number 10, and the new boy, Matteo Johnson. It's really disappointing in the first leg. Zhao were hoping that he's going to have a good evening. Tessa Arnhem have a reputation for being rather better away from home than at home. Hasn't been so in the league, and since the first leg, they've drawn one match at home and lost one away. But as far as the UEFA Cup is concerned, they've won against Bucharest, against Rapid Bucharest in Bucharest, which gave them a 2-1 aggregate score. And away to Werder Bremen, they were 2 goals down and down to 10 men, but they fought back for a 3-3 draw and went through on a 5-4 aggregate. That could be a rather different team than the one we saw in the first leg, Trevor.
Well, particularly first half, they looked a bit overawed. I thought last half an hour they did quite well, and one of the players who we thought did well, Mustafa, is sitting on the bench at the moment, but they brought the more experienced Peters in. What they don't want to do is concede some sloppy soft goal early on.
Yes, Stefanovic. In a manner of speaking, wins a goal kick. Former Sheffield Wednesday player. But good support, those who travel from Arnhem. And they would tell you that the man who missed an absolute sitter, Kalle Sonne, which would have made the score 1-1, you remember the shot from Mustafa, came back off the post, and Sonne somehow managed to play it wide of the post. He had an almost identical situation in a league match against the Graafschap on the Saturday, which followed that first leg. It was on his other foot and he scored. Stefanovic and Chris Kirkland taking charge. Even Dragoslav Jevrić taking charge, you may have noted. To Liverpool supporters, as indeed is this man, Vladimir Smica. Never seems to have a halfway. He's either brilliant or not quite invisible. Useful ball in. It's very, very well taken. Two players coming in, and then the ball hit with pace from the side. Chris Kirkland, and we've got him in the right goal now, at least I have. Did really well.
Did very well. And Moa, it was, who popped up on the right-hand side, drove in a very good cross at the near post, and I think Peters got there almost at the same time as Kirkland.
Traore. Free kick against Demar. 21 matches he's sat on the bench for playing in the Premiership on Saturday. He'd had one Worthington Cup match previously this season. Owen wants it back, gets it back. Space on the left side if it comes over for Smica. Murphy well forward, just outside the box. Gerrard going through the tackle, showing pace, won't get any further. Good clearance by Torel Frankel. He was another who had a good second half. He's provided some good crosses from the left towards the end of the contest. Here is Smica. Away by Cavalesi. Vicious German referee. Let's look again. This good piece of play by the goalkeeper. Eyes on the ball. Got his body there. That's the double block, as it were. Hands got the ball. Ancho. Comfortable turn. Smica. Marin and Stefanovic. No problems for Jevrić, who you'll recall had an excellent game, denying Owen twice and Smica on a 1-1 in the first half of the game a fortnight ago.
He was very quick off his line, Jevrić. Wasn't totally impressed with him on crosses, but certainly he rushed out on 1-1s extremely well.
Stefanovic. Peters coming in from the right side. Bit of pulling by Traore, and maybe it was six or one, half a dozen of the other. Good play by Smica, helping out the Frenchman. Good pressure from Vitesse, who certainly have started better than a fortnight ago. Sign of anxiety. He's been very calm all the way through the worrying period, and he's kept it in bounds for himself and indeed for his team, I suspect. Steven Gerrard, Jimmy Childe. Gerrard. It's Juve. Going from right to left forward. Free kick against the Belgian Klaassens. Joined by his countryman in tonight's lineup, Peters. Murphy on the ball. How a player can protest for a free kick given for a challenge when the ball had left about half an hour earlier is beyond me. But they all do it. And here's another. Young Jonsson, who offended the referee, but they're much sharper in the challenge than they were on their own pitch. Here's Owen, might need to be. Well, it curled the wrong way for him. Michael Owen, who's two goals short of Ian Rush's European tally of 18, should really be level with it already. Chances missed in the first leg. Curiously, 15 of those of his goals have been scored away. He's got 18, Russia's got 20.
Just obviously at home when his pace is such a factor in his play, his defences do defend that much deeper, so it's much harder for Michael to get behind defences.
Marshall. Back for company. Not the best of clearances by Frankel. On by Jonsson. Smica. Levchenko trying to stop him. Ukrainian against the Czech. Gerrard.
Well, I think Steven Gerrard can hit a ball well, but what was that, 40 odd yards out? Look how far, right near the arc of the set. The circle, there's people out wide. Murphy and Carragher in a good position, and Jevrid, I don't think he's going to be worried from that distance.
Peters missed the first leg because he was ill. And his colleague not on the same wavelength. Mona Lisa. Ciao. Jamie Carrick. Frankel quickly to him and then to the next man and was a little bit late. Pretty unrecognisable, aren't they, in terms of determination prepared to put a foot in?
Well, the ball that Klaas has just played through, Frankel was in. If he hadn't overhit that, they'd won possession. The way they play, they've got four at the back, three quite close in the centre of midfield, and then Amoah behind the front two, which really means for Liverpool, the two fullbacks are going to be there out. And so you need Traore and Carragher, who are not the greatest getting forwards, to actually double up. Schmeitzer and Murphy have actually started as wide midfield players, but unless the two fullbacks get forward and overlap, the extra man is not going to be the potent weapon that we thought it might be. And at the moment, as you can see, quite relaxed the visiting fans, because at present you've got to say they're not being troubled.
They've dropped down from 11th to 12th in the Dutch league, a league of 18 teams. Lisa, Jevrid. Position for a decade. Usually you have a pretty guaranteed place in the top six. I didn't see the first leg, they've had a lot of financial problems and lost some key players in the summer because they had to be sold. It's a fairly familiar story. Schmeitzer. Beautiful his route to Murphy, goalkeeper off his line again very well. He really is quick.
So he comes out very quickly. It's good ball for Schmeitzer. Murphy showed himself well on the half turn. He looks into it, just knocks it that couple of yards away from him. That gives the opportunity to Jevrid to show his ability to get out and close them down.
Only Arid in the 6 yard box. Solid header out. Klaasens. Well, the flag didn't go up, but it wasn't the best organised back line. That's the goalkeepers, comfortably.
Again, the man they spread it to with Jamie Carragher is in acres of space, and in the end, it wasn't the best of crosses. Didn't find anyone out. And that's why Traore and Carragher, they can pick it up all the time, but got to make sure the delivery is better than that. Quarter of an hour, which has presented a few slightly different problems for Liverpool. Hajduk, Schmeitzer,
possession, referee let it go. Schuf. Free kick. Impressed with the way that Vitesse Arnhem are prepared to stand their ground physically. At the opening of the first leg, it was boys against men in that area. Frankel's done well again. That's a good talent throw by Murphy. Well seen by the Ukrainian, Chenko. The Belgian, Klassens. Now a Dutchman, Janssen.
Well, a good catch by Kirkland, but it should be a comfortable one, but certainly dominated the penalty area when asked so far.
Murphy. Frankel. Amaro's got forward alongside Peters. Bamba still out on the left. Canalisa. Janssen. Not the sort of form he showed when he first came into the side. Loss of control by Bamba. Again, when Vitesse were in a promising position. Different script between Smitsa and Mitsjoub. Konalisa. Straight through, Konalisa. And must be! But it wasn't. Hit the post, Peters. But they were all over the place, Liverpool down this left side.
Oh, it was a delightful cross, hanging there, asking to be put into the net. Really was, and you know, picked a good position, Peters. Kirkland covering the near post, has to scamper across. It just looks as if he must put it in, and well, he must hit it the outside of the post. We should get a clearer picture of how close it was, but well, there's no excuse, is there? Should have scored.
Different player, opposite post, but again, a total gift missed by Vitesse Arnhem. One in the first leg at the end. One in the second at an early stage. Frankel. Not always too sure where he's heading the ball defensively, but he gets there. Peters with a bit to make up. I think that owes something to his frustration at his dreadful miss. That's Konalisa. Beg your pardon. Picture and commentary were both wrong. That was Klassens we looked at last time. Two slightly short of hair. Offside flag against Owen. Not too much doubt of the correctness of that one. Chenko. Janssen. Oh, pity for him. Murphy. Hajouf. Carragher hanging back. Nicely on, and this is Owen. And at the second time of asking, Owen makes it 2-0 on aggregate. One short of Rush's record.
Score Liverpool's first goal, number 10, Michael Owen.
Well, it's a great ball there by Danny Murphy. This is the first one. Jevrich does very well, and a bit lucky, you've got to say, Michael Owen, to get the second chance. This time on his left foot. and you don't give him two chances. Just goes under then Yevrich's body to try to spread himself again. One-on-one with the keeper, you just thought he'd got away with it again, that goalkeeper. But certainly Liverpool just needed that. They were just beginning to waver, and so were the crowd.
I think you'd have to say they are fortunate to be a one goal up. But it was a delightful ball by Murphy. Frankel. And Frankel arguing with the referee. Owen, the scorer. Danny Murphy, very much the creator. And also, I've got a good deal of sympathy for Dragoslav Yevrich. Big test now for Vitesse. Gerrard, oh, that's a great ball. Very well taken by the goalkeeper, but beautifully curled. Somebody who occasionally sat in your chair and occasionally sat in Gary Lineker's chair would call nice little school. Support on his left side, but he didn't need to be challenged in the way that Jao was challenging him and conceding the free kick. Peters on the line with the right-hand post. Further back is Levchenko, beaten to it by Traore.
Who we said got a lovely left foot and then proceeded to about six or seven bad free kicks. Can he make up for it?
It was covered by Kirkland, but it perhaps says something about his problems with his free kicks in the first leg. That was probably the best we've seen, but this, as far as Liverpool supporters are concerned, is the best seen so far. Tucked under the body of Yevrich at the end by Michael Owen.
Great little ball by Danny Murphy, but got to say the most experienced defender, Stevanovic, was the wrong side of Michael Owen, and he's not a pacey defender, and just a surprise he got caught out.
Owen again. Smica. Oh, Tube goes to the middle. Owen to his right. Jao forward, Gerrard forward, Hepia forward. The keeper thinks about it. And they get away with it a bit, Contessa.
I think that's where Yevrich is not quite so good on the crosses. It was nowhere near. I must say, I thought Hoopy had got above everyone and was just going to plant it into the net. Somehow they got away with it.
Coach of Vitesse, Mike Snowy. His first season in charge, having come up through the youth side and the reserve side. Take over from Ronald Koeman. That's a good challenge. Traore. Jump. Oh dear. Goal kick is what the referee's given. Not too sure about that, but Jao should be a little embarrassed.
Well, Jao trying to get it on his favoured right. That's in those positions, you've got to take a chance with your weaker foot, just whip it in with the left. And the time he tried to get it onto his right, somebody chased back and he was dispossessed.
Chest. Good cover by Hepia.
Frank was just gone down there as well, Barry. He's got, have knocked it out to bring on the physio, something with his right ankle, I believe.
John David Maguire to please contact your nearest police officer. John David Maguire.
Referee allowing attention to be given. Just the way he fell, I think, more than anything else.
Yeah, just got his ankle tucked under him, as you can see, slides in. If you just watch the right ankle, just bends, takes all the weight then, and he tries to whip it out, but perhaps he just turned it over a bit.
He's an interesting player, isn't he?
It's pretty good going forward, nice natural left foot. Doesn't necessarily look totally confident in the defensive areas, but certainly every opportunity that he gets forward, he backs his man up, whether he can carry. I mean, it's his right foot, so that's a plus, because most of the time he does like to use his left, but it's whether he can just put his weight on it.
Looks as though he'll be okay. A Dutchman, but born in Suriname. Third club in Holland. He played for Telstar and De Graafschap. Recovery by Klessens. Remember, not staying onside. Thought he'd done it, but he hadn't.
I'm not sure about that. I thought Traore, the left back, might have played him on actually when the ball was played. Let's have a look. When the ball's clipped in, he just creeps his way back. It was tight, probably a half a yard, but risky.
Gerrard. Carragher. Curious and surely unnecessary return ball to Jamie Carragher.
All about confidence, and although they're 1-0 up, you can certainly see where it's been a bit flat, a bit edgy, and it's still not a convincing display.
Absolutely right. Smitsa, good challenge, and Elisa In contrast, the Dutchman, well, the Dutch team, a variety of nationalities, seem to have adopted an approach where we've got nothing to lose, let's go out and play and show them that we're a rather better team than we showed in the first leg.
They have shown that already. The frustration for them may be the chance that they got just before Liverpool scored. It's such a golden one, and it was squandered by Peters. It looks dangerous, Hoopier, every time it comes in. He actually is put off a bit by Jao, who's just in front of him. I think any decent cross in there, and Liverpool could quite add to their tally.
Schmitzer. Say that both Jao and Elhad Stup are really struggling to be a part of the collective movement, aren't they?
Yeah, Elhad Stup for me has been a big disappointment. I think when he first came the first couple of games, he looked quite bright and alert, but it hasn't really figured. I think Jao's done quite well as the holding role, but of course he and Amar quite often together are similar.
Out by Carragher. Gerrard. Murphy. Flag was up anyway, so it wouldn't have counted. Referee allowing play to continue. Frankel. Make the most of that. Terry Johnson. Moa. Mbamba. To start them off this time, Schmitzer. Had some lively running, but always found the pass at the end of it.
Good interception again by Michael Johnson. He's done very well, I think, in his game coming into the side like this at Anfield. Quite daunting, but he's settled in very well.
It's certainly a plus for Vitesse that they've been able to blood two totally raw players in terms of first team football in the two legs. Aldridge Raya in the first, who came off the subs bench to make his debut. This is Murphy. Owen, still. Interesting block, very effective by Cornelissa, putting the foot back. Amoa. Collect. Frankel again.
Substitution for Vitesse Arnhem.
I think he's going to have to leave.
Viewing the field, number five, Pearl Frankel. Coming on for Vitesse, number seven, Riga Mustafa.
That's an unfortunate loss for Pearl Frankel. Clearly troubled by the ankle, which he found right underneath the full weight of his body. And coming on in his place, it's a man who made an impression in the later stages of the first leg, Riga Mustafa.
Yeah, to put Klassen's to left back, as you can see now, just going out to close down. And really, you know, Mustafa will come in as one of the midfield three.
And immediately into the action. Johnson. determination from Moncho. And some. It wasn't really appreciated. Gerard on the bench recently, getting his chance to find his form again. Murphy. Just too much weight on the pass, but the idea was good. Very well dealt with again by Jan. Most of the noise is coming from our left. Since the goal defended by Dragoslav Jevrić. Not affected by the cold, clearly. Kalisa. Corner one by the persistence of Ireland players. Terry Jansen coming to take the corner.
Now, can he get over that near post, make sure it doesn't get cut out? Good opportunity. And into the last 10 minutes of this half. Just need to put a bit of pressure there on the home defence.
Comfortably away. A job. Thompson having a few words to warm the evening air. Of all. Gerard Houllier, Trevor, has said that what they need to stop the run is, if necessary, a scrappy 1-0. It would be a little harsh to say it's scrappy, but it's certainly not easy going here for Liverpool, who lead 1-0.
No, it's not good. I tend to agree with Alan and Mark, though. I think they need more than the win. I think you need to get a bit of confidence, individuals as well as the team unit. And at the moment, their play, the possession football, the movement, it isn't there. It isn't as convincing as it usually is with Liverpool. So although they're one up, this up to now is not the performance I don't think the team was looking for.
Having got a goal, really, when play didn't deserve it, was certainly harsh on the visitors. Just not been able to build on it at all. And Vitesse have not even checked their stride in any way. Difficult time for Gerard Houllier, because they made their best start ever in the Premiership. Suggested themselves as candidates for the Premiership title. But too many players since have dropped well below the form of which they're capable.
Well, pairing of Mike Lowe and Earl Hedges doesn't quite seem to be a pair. And then, for me at the moment, certainly the midfield unit is not functioning. Steven Gerrard still not dominating as we know he can. Jow's a little bit edgier than I've seen him in other games. Probably Danny Murphy is the better, but he's flitted in and out. And Speecher again having one of those indifferent evenings. And certainly the two fullbacks, Drury and Carragher, not coming forward and pushing up as home fullbacks at present. couple of Michael Owen chances. One of them, of course, he got the goal. Other than that, not too much to worry, Jevrić.
They confirm, in case you had doubts about it, that Emil Heskey is not fit, which is a loss to what most people think is the best partnership up front, with Heskey playing down the middle rather than the curious position that both the international manager and the club manager give him on the left side, of course alongside Michael Owen.
When I've seen him together, I think Barosz plays better with Owen than El Hadjiff, because he played in the first leg and they linked up for the goal there.
True. Murphy. Turn by Murphy. Zhao. Janssen. Asking a lot of Mbemba. But again, he's making life difficult.
Bamba and Moura are quick, got a lot of pace, and they just try and knock those diagonal angled balls towards the corner just to turn the Liverpool defence around. Once or twice they have gotten worried.
They're battling for them, which they didn't in the first leg. Peters underneath it. Two went for the same ball. Jao's head, I'm sure he went with him. Not away yet. Peters got his body in a nice position. Comes off Janssen. Onsho, untidy. Finally to Owen. Goes to Stefanovic. Hadjiff. Traore, somewhat reluctantly coming forward, it seems. Two minutes of the half. Too strong. Lisa. Gerrard, covered by Stefanovic. Had a very tidy game so far. Stefanovic. Across again. He was a little fortunate in the end. Peters. Moa. Theo Janssen. Didn't really get it under control, but he got a good ball back. Oh, Moa! Good stop. Hit it very cleanly indeed. So it struck slightly across the ball. Look where Chris Kirkland was.
It was a bit of a miscue from Janssen. Certainly Moa then hit it well enough. Kirkland certainly just beyond the six-yard box. Always a comfortable height for him to deal with it. And of course, every opportunity Vitesse must push forward. They're going to get through this time. They have to score twice now.
Been greatly employed, but everything he's done has looked really clean and full of confidence. Shows an authority in his goal.
that indeed, in fairness, Dudek did for the whole of last season at club level. And we've reached half-time. And missed by Peters when the goal was at his mercy. Made that much worse for Vitesse Arnhem by the double chance that fell to Michael Owen, created by Danny Murphy, that gives Liverpool a 2-0 aggregate advantage, Owen scoring once so far in either leg. But collectively, Liverpool certainly have yet to clear their heads from all their recent problems. Well, it's rather more straightforward here. Liverpool lead by 2-0 on aggregate. One goal in either tie. In the leg of the tie, but still waiting for the real Liverpool to return. Michael Owen, scorer of both goals in this third round tie. I suppose there are a few choices as to who Santa would support, but it looks very festive. Just in the unlikely moment of Vitesse managing to pull back the two-goal deficit by scoring twice, they would go through, and Mike Snowy there, young manager, 39 last Wednesday week, would have a memorable scalp in his locker. He'd go through all the way goals. Hardly likely. Gerard Houllier looking for a performance with the busy schedule over Christmas and the New Year coming up that would lift the club as a whole and restore the confidence that was so clearly there at the beginning of the season. Supplied the cross that Peters didn't make, and this time Amara doesn't make because Liverpool had got in the way. Right start to the second half by the visitors. Peters coming for the shorter one, but not able to control the ball, and acknowledging the error.
Terrific cross by Cornelisi, and I've got to say, well done, Sammy Hoopier. Key headed clearance.
Met by the skipper again. Owen. Lisa. Once more, and once more, Sammy Hoopier. Second time unchallenged. Sarah Jansen. Lachenko to Klassen, the Belgian. The Ukrainian. Oh, that's a bad one. And it was also badly controlled by Spitzer. See what's on. Time to find a useful ball. The youngster got away with a fairly poor challenge there, but Murphy's not going to get what he was hoping for.
They just tried to chest it to the young lad, just nudging into the back there. Nothing significant enough to warrant the referee pointing towards the spot, but he's got to be careful. It's all part of learning at his young age.
Piece of it.
McIlhurry looked up to see who it was. Smica. Comes off to Mustafa. And appealing for a handball from the top end. Across the park, man in possession being put under pressure, and it has to go all the way back. And up push Vitesse. And this, I think, will be Stefanovic's ball, and it was. Good recovery by Jao. Murphy. Over and unmarked, but it didn't reach him. Owen down. Smica. Nicely slipped. Gerrard. Well claimed. The previous attack down that side brought a great shout of a handball. Gerrard finding the goalkeeper in good form.
Into the chest of Jao, and certainly as Amoa just broke then, just then toe-ended it past, invited to challenge, brought him down, and that warrants the yellow card. Now a dangerous position.
His second card in Europe this season, I'm sure. Three, of course, brings the suspension. Amoa. Kirkland having to backtrack, not troubled.
Just momentarily, I think Kirkland might have thought, oh, quick, get back. He's very tall, though. He thought it was going to be the cross, and it was one of those slightly overhit. And he just wondered whether it was going to squeeze in just below the angle of the far post, but it didn't. Was an indication that Jamie Carragher just getting possession in the opposition half as what you would hope to be the attacking fullback, and there the areas where he and Traore this evening, you know, haven't ventured and haven't looked comfortable and haven't added to the attacking width for the home team.
Oh, everybody coming tight, and Murphy finds his pass that was aimed for Gerrard, blocked by Stefanovic.
Well, Michael Owen, look at Michael Owen, he wants the early ball. Look, he's in front of his man, he wants it now, but he didn't look up, and by the time then he drifts in, Stefanovic closes him down, and Michael Owen turns away in frustration because he again got 2 yards ahead of his marker.
Is at the back, beaten to it by Peters. Sorry, a little uncertain. Good tackle by Peters. Owen. Oh, he's done well, because he took two into the corner with him. Free kick is for Liverpool.
Oh, it's a bit unlucky when you get penalised, Levchenko, a decent block, and it's only knee-height as Traore is going to volley it across. And that certainly these set pieces, corner kicks and free kicks from these angles, they have struggled to deal, particularly with Hoopier.
He's just inside the area. 4 Liverpool players in front of him. And the referee just willing to sort out a minor skirmish in the middle. Stefanovic pleading innocence. Captain comes across to have his say. And it beats everybody. And Hoopier makes a point to the referee, and the crowd made a point to the referee a few moments ago whether this was handball, and it clearly was by Mustafa. Official on this side looking across, gave it, but the cop shouted. By no means a full cop, by no means a full Anfield. But they were certainly right then, off the gloved hands. Shoof. Carragher. This is the first time he's been in the last third in the match. Free kick is given against Smica. The man who's down has suffered a broken leg which affected his career, and he really must have felt that.
Well, the clumsy tackle. Fortunately, Smica stretches, so there's not a lot of follow-through. I mean, it was a bad tackle, but it didn't have his weight behind it, otherwise Jonsson would have had a very nasty knock.
Quite lucky not to be booked for it.
Just been turned on the halfway line, tracked him back well, and in the end, he just toe-ended it away. Sometimes Smica just like to see him go down the final. He can use his left foot. Why doesn't he cross it early on the run rather than keep turning back inside?
Nothing needs to be said about the corner. Murphy.
I was so lucky there, and Michael Jonsson did well actually. Not sure if he knew that Michael Owen was lurking behind him, but also the hooked back defensive knock there could easily have gone straight to Michael Owen, who was in an offside position, but of course would have been played on.
Murphy. interception again by Jonsson. Michael Jonsson.
Second half, there it is, first time, and one-on-one, you think El Hadjouf has got to go and twist and turn and really take the initiative himself, but he actually just released the ball for Murphy, and I just think a confident El Hadjouf, as you said, would have gone for broke himself.
It's a conundrum which has bothered so many coaches. Confidence, how do you do that? Fifth corner for Liverpool. Joao found a bit of space but wasn't seen. Out by Cornelissa. Traore, who's the back man. Liverpool in control of the tie at 2-0. On aggregate, 1-0 on the night. But even so, you can hear from the crowd's reaction, finding life very hard.
It just had a good few minutes of pressure, and then you had two, one by Traore, and I think the next was by Jia, two long balls back to Kirkland, where they could have knocked them in themselves, the two defenders, and suddenly had Kirkland hitting an 80-yard ball into no one from a long distance.
Clearance by Kirkland. Levchenko. Mustafa. Mustafa. Cornelissa, shown he can cross a ball well, but he's crossed this too long. But in fairness to him, they shouldn't have all got sucked in for the right post. Winning, but they're not winning well. Set the standards by which you're judged, and the standards that Liverpool were setting at the start of the season, when, as Gary Lineker said at the start of the programme, they were only a month or so ago 7 points clear in the Premiership, they're now down to fourth. It's by those standards that they're judged, and by those standards that they're now failing.
Is how much they want to sort of think of the weekend's Premiership game or sort of bring changes here. I mean, naturally, Barros could come on up front and could also introduce the likes of Reece and Babel to get forward from fullback better, perhaps, but perhaps he'll leave it as it is.
Match against Sunderland on Saturday. held Liverpool here in a scoreless match. Lost this week to Manchester City comprehensively in what was described as their worst performance of the season. That's awkward. And Stefanovic saying, why are you giving me a ball like that? But Michael Johnson, credit to him, gets back to try and sort it out and possibly apologises to his skipper.
I'm sure Sunderland players are watching this home game on Sunday. Liverpool got a couple of days getting out over that, but it's a crucial one for both sides. Liverpool desperately need to win it, and Sunderland need to get back to winning ways.
Gerrard, early ball, but it's not going to work.
To go, because one goal would make it a little bit more nervy.
And here's Owen, who's offside.
Another delightful little run when the ball is played. Is he off? Yes, just a yarder. Again, always looking to get to the wrong side of their markers.
Yes, he's a constant threat, but he's actually the only threat. Murphy, Owen, and more concerned to argue the point with the referee rather than try to get the ball. Carragher, Owen, oh, he needs some attention, that's why he sat down.
He was asking him to knock the ball out. Nobody would knock it out, and then he thought, well, if he got on the floor, that might persuade him. Then Michael Owen just stopped the play, and there he's got up. Well, that was quite amusing, that one there.
It looks as though he's going to be replaced. Matthew Amoah. They're going to bring another youngster into the fray, Michael Dinsdag. 20 last October, made his debut a year ago, but hasn't had very much first team experience. Been a bit of a change around, because he's normally a defender. Gerrard. Oh, well played, Klessens. And again, how can he get away? Well cut out by Onsho. Jump. Smita. Well, the substitution's about to be made, and both sides. Andy Harmon on the right as we look. It's going to be one. Fourth official. And it's Zhao who comes off to be replaced by Hammond. In spite of his exploits in the World Cup, as I suggested at the start, being the most consistent player in the Liverpool lineup this season. Got his first taste in the UEFA Cup this season. firm. Zhao off, Harman on, and Dinsdag is on in place of Amoa.
Yeah, Harman really a straight swap with Zhao, and Dinsdag has gone on to the left back position, which releases Klassens, who had moved there in the first half, back into the midfield, and looks as if he'll try and play just, you know, that midfield role, and perhaps Jonsson, the number 10, is going to get that little bit closer to Ndamba and Peters.
Carragher's pushed on for the return ball. Still available, but now dropping back. Gerrard, there's no width there. Until Smica found a good position, and Jonsson who gets it away.
Well, it's a good ball by Gerrard. Smica took it in his stride well. I just think have a go with the left foot, and comes back inside into that congested area again.
Problem does stand out like a sore thumb, doesn't it?
Well, the width either side. I mean, Danny Murphy, you know, is a mired midfielder as well, but no one just likes to go outside any of the defender and get to the byline and get crosses in, and you just keep turning into trouble, and they're so narrow, and particularly, as we've been saying, when the two fullbacks aren't going beyond the wide midfielders. Do anything that he did there, he pushed it away from trouble, but again Peters, the header, and now this one, two great chances.
Again, as you say, it was at a comfortable height, but his eyes were speaking volumes then, the goalkeeper. Absolutely determined, you will not pass me, that's handball. The referee says accidental, that's the third handball that he's allowed to go. One of them might well have been a penalty.
I think the thing I also about Chris Kirkland, he's a very big, formidable figure, and when you're bearing down him, you look ahead, you think, goodness me, how do I get past this frame, and certainly how that, I think, intimidates the attackers a bit.
Smica, all right. Had a really tidy game, Stefanovic. Yugoslav international. Made 100 appearances for Sheffield Wednesday. Yep, yep. Down the left side. Harman. There's Gerrard. And over on this side is Owen. Well, he's done well. And difficult for this man. Jerzy Dudek. Made his mistakes. And I'm sure will come again. He's a quality goalkeeper. Kirkland determined to seize his chance because it offers so much.
Well, that's the problem of the position, isn't it? Goalkeeping one, if the man in possession does the business, then you could be there weeks and weeks, and certainly it's there for now Kirkland to try and stay in there.
last save. Chris Kirkland is coming forward saying, beat me if you can. That's the strength, no doubt about that. Trying to get it through, does it the second time of asking, Stefanovic. And again, did he have it? It's nice. Again, took his time and he wasn't given his time by the younger Janssen. Owen demanding the ball back. Clear comfortably.
Yeah, well done, Cornelis, because that was electrifying. A little acceleration by Michael Owen going into the penalty area. He had to make sure when they made the challenge, Cornelis, it was the right one, and it was.
That's off the face, says the referee. Gaffia. Not the best of passes by the captain. Just caught sight of Yanana Risa warming up then. I'm sure the crowd would like to see him.
He could come on instead of Smith on the left of midfield, or in left back instead of Traore. And with just the natural left foot, it'll put some good early crosses in, I'm sure.
What a time, you may remember last season, Trevor, when he was actually saying to the manager, I'm actually a midfield player, not a defender. And Julio was rather saying, I will decide where you'll play. At the moment, he's not a first choice, it would seem.
He was outstanding last season. I've got to say, his form hasn't been as good this time around.
Mustafa didn't see the arriving Cornelisa. Now, Steven Gerrard. He's been quite a spell on that left side. Going wide. Smica, Gerrard, Smica, nobody in the box at the moment for Liverpool. Dead. The ball had gone out, it's a goal kick. Again, ending a Liverpool attack. And he's had a really good game for me. Quite a few in the Vitesse Arnhem side have certainly done their confidence. I would have thought quite a bit of good, even though they're on the losing side. Didn't buy. The substitution will now be made for Liverpool. Risa, having warmed up sufficiently, comes on in place of Al Hajjouk. Oh, in fact, he's come. Well, it's Hajjouk who has gone off.
Seven went up, didn't it?
Say seven, yes.
Smita started jogging across, and then El Hajjouk seemed to say, look, I've had enough, I'll come off. And Smita's now gone through the middle as the second striker, really, with Owen, and Reese has gone over on that left-hand side.
Gerrard. Smita. Bringing Reese into the game, but not the easiest to take. J.
chance for him to impress and find the form of last season.
Got a few crucial goals as well, spectacular goals for Liverpool last season.
Lost control of it. It's stuck. Oh, it's a bit short. Charge for the counter here. All sorts of options. Smitsa in possession. Gerrard to the right. Owen forward. Smitsa to Anarisa. Oh dear. A little summary then of Liverpool's problems. They had so many options then. And the Liverpool of earlier in the season would surely have made an incisive thrust, and there would at least have been a shot on goal from somebody.
And you get a break like that, you've got to give the ball early. The more you carry it and carry it and get near the penalty area, then the more and more the options gets closed down. And in the end, Vitesse did very well. They shut out the Liverpool, Reece out wide, but certainly the ball should have been played much early.
Peters. Terry Johnson. Malika Mustafa. Space here for Cornelissa. Likes the long cross, in comes Peters. Hope you beat him. Back on the Owen goal. Came in the first half, if you've joined us late. And it came really at a time when Liverpool were really having a bit of a struggle, and Arnhem were playing far, far better than they played in the first leg. And they've continued to do that. Certainly improved their reputation, those who judged them first time around.
Just needed was another goal. Liverpool, from their point of view, needed this, the second goal, and that gave them the extra cushion. While this is still 1-0, and if Vitesse did get a pinch and equalise, then suddenly you do get a twitchy little remaining spell of the game. But Vitesse, they've had a couple of great chances. Petters had that second one about 10 minutes ago, but they haven't been able to take them, and that's why at the moment Liverpool still coping quite comfortably.
Gerrard, Carragher, good angle run by Owen, not used. And here's Mbemba. Oh dear. I suppose you can't fault ambition, but I don't think he knew if there was a colleague anywhere near him who was going to play the ball to. He was just going to go for glory.
Must have been one. He must have had a dream last night. He scored a 50-yarder or something, because that's how far he was out.
See some empty seats, you've been watching them, I'm sure. Well, at least not watching the seats, but observing them as the ball has gone by. 23,576, size of the crowd. Not what you expect at Anfield. Mustafa. I don't know who he saw over there. And they're looking rather frustrated now, the Dutch team. Really, that wasn't a good piece of play.
Yeah, his manager sort of left him on the bench, which when the team was announced was a little bit surprised. I thought Mustafa did, or was their most threatening player in the first leg, but since coming on he's been a bit disappointed. Never looked as if he's going to go past anyone on the outside, and tended to come in like he did then, and and just pass the responsibility.
Owen, still chasing the hat-trick. Would have been his third of the season if he was to get it. Over the tie, of course. He's only got one in this match. This is Classen's. Dodgy. Liverpool might still be on. Johnson. That's a corner.
That was a shame. It was a great crossfire. And Bamba, but of course he's one of the two strikers, and Peter's not really the quickest, and went right across the face of the six-yard box, just begging for somebody to get a toe into it. Gave him a big build-up in the first leg. He's had three tonight. I think we've got to withdraw the fact that he's got a good left foot. Now it must have been an illusion that I'd said he had a good left foot.
This one Aaron is chasing seriously is matching Ian Rush's 20 goals in European football. And Elisa! Inside the last 5 minutes. And Vitesse Arnhem looking for a consolation. Rather rushed it when Traore closed him down.
The reaction of players and fans suggested it just clipped one of the Liverpool defenders and that they should have got the corner. I thought Cornelius has probably been one of the better players, I must say. I thought he's dealt with Schmitz pretty well and defended and covered people whenever they looked a little bit uncertain. He's just inside him. He's got the youngster, Michael Johnson, who I think has done well. Certainly in a difficult match for him, he's looked pretty comfortable as a teenager.
Does Liverpool have the plus of staying in Europe into the new year? There's a break from European football now, but Vitesse Arnhem have many pluses in terms of their own league, because they've played a lot better than they've been playing recently, I would have thought. Certainly better than the first leg. Whereas you can't, in all honesty, say that's true about Liverpool giving themselves a boost for the Premiership.
No, the good fact is they've got through the UEFA Cup competition. They can tuck it away for 8 to 10 weeks, see who they get in the draw tomorrow, and then really focus on trying to rediscover that Premiership form. But it's a 1-0 win, and the aggregate looks reasonably comfortable. You cannot say that too much is going to be taken of this confidence-wise to go into the Premiership.
Waiting to come on. Maybe an early departure for Michael Owen. Opia arriving but not getting the meat of the forehead on the ball.
Just couldn't quite keep it down. One of the two strikers had to come. Schmitz has just been moved forward, hadn't he, when Al Hadjouf went off? But now it is his turn. I'm sure his number went up at the first occasion. But Barros just coming on. I thought Michael Owen might be rested. But I thought this pairing might be the one that started this evening, but it wasn't to be.
Well, they started the tie a fortnight ago. And Barros put Owen in for his first goal. And scored, of course, in the second as well.
Ivanovic. Gets the free kick. Chance of going in, two players between him and the goal, two colleagues placed in the box for the burst.
Feared the worst of the outcome when you saw his left leg going back, winning some spectacular strike, but a bit of frustration for them. There's certainly, as you say, take a few positives. A 1-0 scoreline is not bad coming away from Anfield, and let's hope they do get that confidence, because certainly it's a club that's had its problems financially and certainly rebuilding and wanting to make sure they at least stay respectably in the Dutch league.
Peters and Bamba and Mustafa, but he won't make it. Some stoppage time to be played. Yeah, it's interesting that Mike Snowy actually said after the first leg he thought it would lift his side by holding Liverpool to one in the home leg. They've certainly been surely more lifted by their performance in the away leg. In comes Barros, goalkeeper loses out. Barros, though denied by Stefanovic. Still Barros. Oh. Well, in the end, it was Jonsson and Michael Jonsson who marks his debut by clearing off the line. Barros, unlucky.
Well, he did well, Barros. Showed that little bit of energy that perhaps Elhachuk didn't. Thought it was dangerous play, but his foot up was on the keeper.
Risa.
That's why I
seen again by Michael Jonsson. Peters.
He's working back well there and knocking it back with his left foot. He had a good header as well through the Barros. I'm pretty sure Risa should figure at the weekend. He certainly looks far better, giving it better shape on that left-hand side.
Thankful for that. He goes to speak to Mike Snowy. Michael Owen scoring in both legs. Both legs won by 1-0.
Ladies and gentlemen,
Chris Kirkland keeps a clean sheet, which is a good start for him back at Anfield as at the moment the number one goalkeeper. But you have to have some sympathy that Vitesse have got nothing to show in the score sheet, but they've certainly got plenty to show in the performance of various players, including young Michael Jonsson making his debut at the back. But Michael Owen scores twice against Vitesse Arnhem, and Liverpool stay on the road in the UEFA Cup. What it's done for their form in the Premiership remains to be seen.
Well, that was a thriller.
A win is a win is a win.
Saying that was basically the same as the first, and they failed to dominate. Vitesse were a better team here than they were a fortnight ago, but obviously more defensive. The onus on them in the first leg was to go and try and get some of the game.
But tonight was all about the result, not the performance.
Well, we said at the start that you know you wanted a great performance, and the tempo would be high, and they'd come out and they'd pass it and move it and get it down, but it just didn't happen for them. And when the confidence is low, then, you know, it's very difficult to get it back. What you need is a little bit of impetus from somewhere, and basically they didn't get it.
Okay, I think they missed out on a chance here because they had a great chance, really, you know, to really bury Vitesse on them, but it just wasn't going to be, was it?
Okay, we'll have another word in just a second because we've got Stephen Gerrard and Michael Owen with Garth Crooks.
Well, Michael, the goal, as always, important. Did you think you'd get a second bite at the cherry?
No, I thought maybe after the occasion, I thought maybe I should have got a little bit closer because I was a bit far away when I shot, so well, I never expected it, but you've always got to be on the lookout. That's what being a striker's all about.
The goal from the ball from Danny Murphy, was superb. The relationship between you and Danny, is that getting better, as it's always been very good?
Yeah, well, I think by now the midfielders know how I like to play the game and where I prefer the balls, and this fella is equally as good, and it's nice to be playing in front of two players like that.
Steve, let's talk about Liverpool's confidence. Lots been made of that. Does this result help your confidence at all, the team's confidence?
Yeah, definitely. It's what we've needed. There's been a lot of talking all week in training. We've worked on a few things. The most important thing tonight was the clean sheet. We've played 4 or 5 Premier League games and it hasn't gone right, and it was up to us to get it right tonight, and I think we can take that into Sunderland now off the clean sheet.
The exit from the Champions League, has that had more impact on Liverpool's overall confidence than you originally thought it would?
Yeah, it was a big blow. You know, we expected to be in at the second phase because we were in the second phase last year, but it wasn't to be. You know, we come up against some tough sides and we got knocked out, but now it's up to us to go and try and win this competition and also have a good crack at the Premier League.
The goal came at a time perhaps against the run of play. Did you ever feel, though, that the result tonight for Liverpool was ever in any doubt?
No, I don't think so. I think with that result that we got away in Arnhem was a good result. And even though it wasn't the prettiest game tonight, I think, when you've lost 4 or 5 in quick succession, then you take anything. And we said before the game it might take a scrappy 1-0 win to maybe turn the corner. And we're not saying we've turned the corner, but hopefully that's something to build on now.
Stephen, you look like you're back to your best. In any way, has there been a sense that your relationship with Gerrard and the way he's actually perhaps forced you and said to you, you know, you've got to get back to your best, it's very important for Liverpool and for your England career, has that had an impact on you?
Yeah, definitely. Obviously, it answers your idea for me to get back to playing the way I should be. You know, it was up down to me. I wasn't playing good enough and it was up to me, but the staff have been fantastic with me, so have my teammates, and, you know, I can feel myself coming back.
Well done tonight, thank you.
Cheers, Rob.
I don't think he was choking at the question. I think he was all right. But, I mean, Michael Owen there, I felt a little bit frustrated. He must do, but the lack of service he's getting at present, do you think? Especially from wide.
Well, he's, you know, Michael thrives in scoring goals. He hasn't scored in 5. He got one tonight. He really hasn't been having that many chances. And obviously, when the chances have been coming, it hasn't been putting away. And it's a confidence factor with the whole side. I mean, I think Hooley's got an individual style of management. And he's very, very single-minded. And the great thing for Liverpool and their supporters is that they've improved every year,
yeah.
Right? Every year. And that is why the people come here and they look at the Liverpool side and say, well, it's all right, because every year since Hooley's been in charge, yeah, they've improved. And I hate harping on about the goal in the olden days when Paisley was manager, but the first thing Paisley would do in a situation like this would go, my best team,
11
my best 11 players, right? Now, I would think that on Sunday against Sunderland, you'd play your best 11. And that I would start.
He doesn't tend to do that nowadays.
Well,
but Gerrard perhaps more than most.
It's the way of getting out of trouble.
Exactly. I think that is the key. When you're in the middle of a slump, whatever you want to call it, that is the way you do it. Because how else can you judge it? And I think you saw straight away that, you know, Milan Baroš comes on for 10 or 15 minutes.
You think he knows his best 11?
Yeah.
Well, it's open to debate what the best 11 is. Yeah. I mean, he'll obviously know his is best 11. But I mean, I would start with Kirkland. You go Carragher, Poncho, Hippier, Risa, left back. Risa, natural left footed, good in the ball, good going forward. Then you'd string 4 across the middle of the park. You'd have Murphy, Haman, Gerrard, and Joe. Right? And then you'd play Owen. If Heskey was fit, I'd play Heskey. Yeah. If not, you play Baroš. And you start that 11 and take it from there.
I think what Hullier has started to do lately, probably the start of this season, is he's almost tried to play 3 up front at times, Smeets is most definitely one of his favourites, and he likes him to play. He very, very rarely just plays him off the lone striker.
He delivers, though, does he?
No, he doesn't, Gary.
Does he?
He hasn't. I think if you ask every single supporter, even the most myopic of supporters, will tell you that at times you look at him and you think, oh, he can play this fella. And then the next five or six occasions you see him and you think, yeah, but what's he done?
Well, one man who does.
There's no doubt he's got ability. He's got great ability. No,
it's never come out.
For the pace of the Premiership, and maybe the strength of the Premiership is his downfall. I don't think he's strong enough. At times he's like he's got to hold it, and
it's
people.
Final are, ball, isn't it, really?
Well, not just the final ball. I think more the strength. I think that when he's on the ball, people will knock him off it. And if you're playing just off the front two, you've got to try and get the ball, get into the game.
One man who always delivers, Michael Owen. Let's remind everyone of the goal that he scored. Yeah. It was a while
Murphy
ago.
Murphy made
now.
It. Great ball in from Murphy. Murphy, if you watch Murphy here, he gets himself in a good position, makes a space. Carragher into feet, ball around the corner. Michael onto it quick. Decent save. But he reacts quicker than anybody else that's in the back of the net.
It's just what he'll always be remembered for, isn't it? Over top, on he goes. Didn't particularly connect well with the first one and made sure he scores with the second. Just grateful of the opportunity.
Great balling from Murphy, Phil. I mean, the ball makes it. Michael on a half turn. And then just the reaction.
Yeah.
It's great.
There was barely a chance in the second half, but the best one fell in injury time, really, didn't it? To Barros, that was the only other time they really looked like scoring.
Every time you watch Barros play, at least he's a threat. He's a threat, you know. The ball's up in the air here. It's a great header on. But he's quick, he's in. He's onto it quick. I mean, I think the defending on the line here is absolutely brilliant. It's a great recovery. But at least he's threatened.
I think the thing with him as well is he's very, very direct when he gets himself in these positions. You know, brave as well going in on the goalkeeper. We just talked about Smeetsen not being strong enough. There's only one thought. Tries a second chance. And in the end as well, it's an extremely good block. But I think him with Michael Owen is the key for me.
OK, now also playing tonight, on Houllier, who's also talking to Garth.
Well, Gerard, you got the result again. Was the victory ever in any doubt? Were you convinced by it?
The most important thing today was to qualify, to go through and get ready for the next round next year. And when you're not through a good spell, when things are not running your way, sometimes the players have a bit of lack of confidence, and I thought that they did a very professional job, and then they deserve a lot of credit, because knowing that we're not doing very well at the moment, we played better games and lost. Today I don't think we played that well, but at least you know, we were sort of very solid, very strong, and showed the desire to go through.
Were there moments tonight where you felt anxious at all about the way you were playing and the way Vitesse were coming at you?
Well, I think with a bit of luck we could have scored a second goal, and that would have probably been more comfortable for us. But once, you know, you're only 1-0 up, an equaliser would have probably boosted their confidence themselves. And don't forget that they were 2-0 down against Bremer and qualified in getting a 3-3. They won also in Bucharest. It's a good team away from home, because they've got some good players. So we needed to be tight, compact, and just contain them.
Well done, Jared. Thank you.
Thanks very much. You can't underestimate the importance of confidence, can you, to a team? You're going through it. We've seen Arsenal go through a bad run recently, Manchester United earlier in the season. You win a couple of games and things can turn around. The same, of course, can be true for Liverpool.
Well, it's like two ends of the stick, isn't it? You go on the pitch when you're so confident, you've been winning matches, and you think, hey, we're invincible here. Yeah. And then the other end is that you go on the pitch and you think, where's my next result going to come from? And just Liverpool are in that way at the minute. I think, basically, it's crunch time for Liverpool this season. They've got three matches before they go to Highbury in the Premiership. They've got Sunderland away, Everton at home, and Blackburn at home. Now, they're 4 points behind Arsenal at the minute. If you go any further behind and then you go to Highbury, then you've got a basic problem. I mean, they're fourth in the league at the minute. You know, 5 weeks ago, they're a certainty to qualify for the Champions League. Yeah. No, you're not quite so sure. The last couple of seasons, when it has been crunch time, they've delivered. Yeah. Right, they've got to deliver again.
Well, it was functional tonight. I think at best it was functional. Vitesse Arnhem not very, very strong. only the results in the next few games will tell you whether tonight was actually a stepping stone for them or not. You know, they go to Sunderland on Sunday. He'll no doubt make changes again, which I don't particularly think helps you either. It helps your cause when you're not playing particularly well, because we said before about having your best team out all the time. I would think on Sunday, Gerard Houllier will pick his best team as near as damn it. And then basically, if they can get a result on Sunday at Sunderland, then you can build up through the Worthington Cup. And as Alan says, three or four games away from Arsenal. You want to go into the Arsenal game
still plenty
winning
to
again.
Play for, though.
Yeah,
well, when we come back here in January, February for the next round of the UEFA Cup, there'll be 15 points in front of the Premiership.
Thanks very much. Well, that's it from Anfield, where Liverpool have marched through to the fourth round of the UEFA Cup. Crisis? What crisis? Good night.